SBR Forum's Inside the Lines is brought to you by Ladbrokes.
We are previewing the College Bowls here at SBR Forum Videos. I'm Peter Loshak. We're talking right now with Doug Upstone from sports-watch.com. Very popular returning guest, Doug Upstone. Thanks for being here with us once again.
Hey, Peter, the bowl season's here. It's a great time of year. Let's make it happen.
Huh? Very, very exciting and fun. We're going to talk about the New Orleans Bowl, East Carolina, and Louisiana-Lafayette first. Before we do, give a little 15-second plug for sports-watch.com.
Sure. Sports-watch. In fact, I talked to a number of the members today that are on the monitor, and they're all really looking forward to this upcoming bowl season, especially 11th Hour Sports from Docs, who finished number one in units for the regular season.
Wow. Very impressive. 11th Hour Sports. We'll try to get him on these previews next year, maybe. What do you think about that? You think he'd come on?
There you go.
Yes, excellent. All right. We're going to talk with you, Doug Upstone, about the New Orleans Bowl, East Carolina, Louisiana Lafayette. This is, of course, being played in New Orleans, so maybe Louisiana Lafayette deserves a bit of a home field advantage here on the spread. They're a six-point favorite. The total 64.5. Now, normally I might be leaning towards Louisiana Lafayette, but I know that East Carolina is, you know, they're taking this bowl very seriously. They finally have a chance to, you know, play a team in the bowl that's on their level. So I'm not sure if I'd want to give them 6 points here. The total 64.5, though, and both these teams have high-powered offenses and defenses that are not that great at stopping other high-powered offenses. So even though the total 64.5 is a little high, if I had to make a bet on this one, that's what I would take, the over.
Yeah, you know, and looking at these two teams, you know, they're both 8-4 and have very similar statistics. And it was interesting to note the line actually opened with Louisiana favored by 4.5 before it jumped up to 6. You know, now the Ragin' Cajuns are going to go bowling for second straight years in a place that they're very familiar with. And, you know, last year they did a great job in their game, with the first one in quite a while. Now, they have a really balanced attack with running back Alonzo Harris, who's a proven workhorse, and quarterback Terrence Broadway, who's really a good dual threat. Now, Harris leads a really stout rushing attack that was 39th in the country. And Broadway took over at quarterback for injured Blaine Gagnier and completed 65% of his passes and had a 2-1 touchdown to interception ratio. Now, the Ragin' Cajuns' run defense was actually good enough to finish 43rd in the country, but they were easier to pass against than a person driving 45 on a 65-mile-an-hour highway. Now, East Carolina comes into this bowl action after a one-year absence and will face what would be considered a hostile crowd going into Cajun country. The Pirates, though, could negate that disadvantage because their quarterback, Shane Carden, will be facing Lafayette's 115th-rated pass defense. Now, East Carolina has a serviceable running game with Ventavious Cooper and two other running backs who will be coming back from injury and will likely share the load. Similar to their opponent, East Carolina has a good run defense but is often victimized by opposing quarterbacks in the air. Now, for bettors, here are the points to consider. As you mentioned, Peter, 64.5 is the total, and the New Orleans Bowl has gone over the total 7 straight years, and we have two strong passing offense against two dreadful defenses. If the connections are made, there is only one way to bet this total. Now, last season, Louisiana Lafayette was jacked for their first bowl game, and they were an underdog, not playing too far from home. But this time, the situation is flipped. The novelty of the situation is gone a little bit, and instead of underdogs, they're now favorites. And reading a number of the East Carolina websites, the Pirates, as you mentioned, Peter, are taking this game extremely seriously. And really, I think they feel dissed for being an underdog against the Sun Belt team, and they have lost 3 consecutive bowl games. Now, with these two teams, in my opinion, fairly evenly matched, when I look at my computer screen and underdogs in East Carolina bowl games, 7-2 against the spread, I will be playing East Carolina and the over.
Wow. Great, thorough analysis. I actually completely agree with both of your leans, and I love how you deal with Ebonics. I love how the word dist rolls off your tongue, and the football players with the unusual names like Ventavious Murray rolls off your tongue. Great preview, Doug Upstone. Thanks.